The Tecno Spark 7P is a budget device from Tecno, which costs about 130 euros. In Ghana, it costs about 750 cedis for the 64GB storage variant, while the 128GB variant is sold at 896 cedis. And for the price, the Tecno Spark 7P offers really good value. But after 1 month, how has this phone aged? Should you still buy this phone? We shall find out coming up next. Have you ever
felt? Are you listening?
Damn. Hi guys, welcome to another edition of Cyber Reviews. Now, regardless of the story type you choose, you get 4 gigs of RAM, which is what you get on an iPhone 11, which costs about 3 times or 4 times the price of the Tecno Spark 7P. You also get an HD IPS LCD display with a 90Hz refresh rate. And this is not a 1080p display, it's a 720p display, similar to what you get on an iPhone 11, but without the 90Hz refresh rate kind of. But before we go deeper into the numbers, let's talk about the design of this phone. The first thing I noticed when I got this phone was the huge Tecno logo at the back of the phone. That's a bold statement that Tecno is making. They don't want you to mistake their devices for any other brand. And that kind of reminds me of the Poco X3 Pro. I am a lover of minimal designs, so less is more. However, the more I use this phone, the more the design grew on me. Let me know in the comments what you think about the design of the phone. Still at the back, we have a camera array of 3 lenses and a fingerprint sensor. The fingerprint sensor is in a good position at the back and works pretty well at unlocking the device. At the bottom of the device, we have a speaker, a microphone port, a headphone port, and a micro USB port. It would have been good if it was USB Type-C, but at this price range, I can't really find a lot of things to criticize. On the left-hand side is where you insert the SIM card tray. Now, the Tecno Spark 7P uses 2 SIMs and a dedicated expandable storage slot. On the front, we have a teardrop notch, which houses the selfie camera. Then you have the secondary speaker for calls and media. So this is a stereo speaker phone. Though the speakers on this phone are not very loud and very rich in clarity. The body of the phone is made of plastic, which makes it durable for long-term use. The screen is made of glass and the phone comes with a screen protector already installed. Speaking of the screen, let's talk about the display of this phone. The Tecno Spark 7P has an IPS LCD display, which has a 720p maximum resolution. At this price point, compromises needed to be made to ensure that the phone delivers good value in terms of performance, battery life, and more. But more on that in a minute. The 90Hz refresh rate makes the phone feel super responsive, and so you won't even feel like you're using a phone which costs less than $200. The screen is not very bright outdoors, but indoors it works well and can be used to play games and consume content. Speaking of gaming, let's talk about the performance of the Tecno Spark 7P. The Tecno Spark 7P is powered by the Helio G70 processor. Now, this is a very good mid-range processor. I could play games like Asphalt on it and it worked pretty well. Do not expect flagship level performance from this phone. It is a budget phone with mid-range specs. Now, 4 gigs of RAM is not a lot, but once you are not running a lot of heavy apps and multitasking, you should be fine most of the time. The Tecno Spark 7P has 5000 mAh of battery capacity and combined with a 720p display and a not too demanding, not too powerful processor, it can last you on average a full day of use. Now, this phone has cameras, but they are not going to be the best cameras you will see on a phone. They are okay, nothing exceptional, and at that price point, I cannot complain, especially since Tecno did not hype the cameras on this phone as being the main features on this phone, unlike what they did for the Tecno Camon 17 series. But my review of the Tecno Camon 17 Pro is coming, so if you have not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing and turn on all notifications so you do not miss that video. Now, you can record videos in 1080p both on the front and the back of this phone at 30 frames per second. It's not the best for creating content, but with enough light, you can make do with what you have. This phone comes with HiOS, which is Tecno's flavor of Android that they have on it. I'm not a fan of it, especially considering that it comes with a lot of pre-installed applications which consume your very small 64 gig of storage or 128 gigs of storage, and some of them you cannot uninstall. And the user interface itself is simple to use. It's okay, nothing extraordinary. You can put a launcher on it, and this one also comes with Android 11 out of the box. So in conclusion, the things I love about the Tecno Spark 7 PR1, it has a big battery, it has a good mid-range processor, and it also has a nice design. Apart from that, you also get 3.5 millimeter port and you get expandable storage, and it's made of plastic, so it's pretty durable. The things I don't like about it are, one, the operating system needs some fine tuning to, you know, provide a good user experience. The cameras are not really powerful, really good, but you can't really blame them at this price point. And I wish the USB port was a USB-C port, that's all. You know, it's a good phone to buy for your grandmother, your grandfather, your brother who is in junior high or senior high, or to use as a backup phone. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below of the Tecno Spark 7P. Is it good value for money or not? Let me know. Thanks, Bibri.